Hello.
What's your name?
My name's Andrew Lancaster.
All right, where are you from, Andrew?
I'm from Lancashire.
And what do you do?
I do impressions.
What's your full-time job, Andrew?
I've done a vast array of jobs.
Like what?
I worked in a biscuit factory.
And tell me why you've entered the show and what the dream is, please.
Well, I suppose the dream would be to have my own impression sketch show one day. It's a big dream, it's a big dream.
Well, that's what it's all about, Andrew. OK, well, look, best of luck.
Thank you very much, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen of the United Kingdom, I, Donald J. Trump, propose some changes to the way you're doing things in your beautiful country. Yeah. Number one, your children, your greatest natural resource. I propose Professor Brian Cox educate each and every last one of them. I think it's going to go something like this.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Well, actually, we do know what you are. I think it's absolutely wonderful.
Number two, I believe that your National Health Service is a beautiful thing, should be in charge by my good friend, Nigel Farage. He's gonna do a great job.
Now, wait a minute, don't do that. I mean, come on. I mean, here we are. It's funny, isn't it? You know, as soon as somebody says my name, everybody goes bonkers. You know, I think it's quite funny. I've got another job.
And finally, number three. Is it number three? I don't know. It doesn't matter. Number three, folks, your housing. You got to get that sorted out, folks. I know just the man for the job. It's Russell Brand, ladies and gentlemen. Russell, do your thing.
No, seriously, right? Yeah, I think the most important thing is, right...
No, you don't know what I'm going to say yet.
But the most important thing, I think, for this country at the moment is to get everybody in a nice little house, you know.
Because where else are you going to live? You know, I can't live in a street, can you? There's a royal wedding going to happen, you know. Not like me, though. I live in a nice big house. I love you, bye-bye!
Those are my ideas for reform in your beautiful country. If you don't like them, you're fake news. Good night, God bless you, and God bless America.
They said it had never happened, folks. They said it had never happened, but here we are, BGT. Britain's got Trump. I, Donald J. Trump, propose more ideas to bring our two beautiful nations closer together. You want to hear my ideas, folks? Idea one, I take another British bodyguard. You got knights in Britain, knights make great bodyguards. So who better than Sir David Attenborough? He's going to do a great job.
This animal from North America is the Thrombosaurus. The Thrombosaurus will make being a bodyguard very difficult, as he responds almost always in a display of aggression to any sign of provocation. He does this during the day by roaring at the cameras when the sun goes down, by sitting in bed, cheeseburger in hand, and, despite his gargantuan size, by tweeting long into the night. Note his remarkably tiny hands.
And we're gonna build that cheeseburger, Sir David. Next, I want someone in charge of my show. You're in it. Britain's Got Trump. This is my show. I created it. I need someone with bigly, it's a word, bigly diplomatic skills and intelligence. It's Boris Johnson, ladies and gentlemen.
No, come on, I've got. I know what's going on. Yes. So, right, you work for me. So, no, wait. Right, no, come on, no more silliness. Right, so we've got Amanda Held Me Holding. No, Dickinson Dancing Woman. Robbie Williams. Williams, Robbie Williams. Yes, no, Williams, him. No, 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 it's the Irish bloke, lives in a castle. Louis Walsh. Yes. Jolly good, jolly good.
Something about that guy's hair I just love. Finally, folks, your Brexit. You gotta get your Brexit sorted out, folks. If you want a trade deal with China, I propose your mucho macho actor, Sean Bean, be in charge. He's a very tough cookie. He's gonna do a great job.
Under the auspices of Donald Trump, I will take my men with sword and shield to France and slay every dragon in the EU. Hey, let's just build a great big wall. Champion.
And I love it. Big, beautiful wall. And who's going to pay for the wall, folks? No, not Mexico. Not Mexico. The others. Folks, these are others. It's a joke. Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. So, folks, these are my ideas to bring our two beautiful nations closer together. But I know what you're thinking. Why would such a beautiful nation want to join forces with a big-headed megalomaniac with far too much money, terrible, terrible hair, and a really weird voice? But, folks, if America wants to work with Simon Cowell, that's no problem. Good night, God bless you, and may God bless Britain's Got Trump.
Hello.
Hello. What's your name?
I'm Darren.
Tell me, do you have a day job?
I'm a voiceover artist, actually.
Oh, for commercials and things?
Yeah.
What product would we know your voice from mostly on the radio?
I am an IAMS cad.
Is this what your act is going to be this evening?
Tonight I'm going to do a few celebrity impressions for you.
I love them.
Brilliant. OK, when you're ready, off you go.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to face the the impressions.
Actually, doing the X Factor guy, all you have to do is, right at the very end, roar like a lion.
Simon Cowell!
Thank you, and here we can witness a whole plethora of strange and fascinating creatures.
That's good.
Nice.
Yes! The obligatory wild pack of street dancers and the balding, middle-aged car enthusiast.
Look at the body on this. I love the sexy curves, the exquisite contours, but most importantly, the two big airbags.
So actually, to do Jeremy, you just have to get a few key points in.
You have to start low, go up like this, pause, and go back down like this. So once you've got your Jeremy, it's very easy
to slip into God. It's all about working it, and looking good.
Hey, 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 big boy, yes, look at me, hey, well done. Yes, to do Corby, you have to jump up and down as if you're absolutely busting for the toilet, yes? And another guy that also talks in quite a breathy manner, who's not a million miles away, ladies and gentlemen.
Do an impression of
what are you doing?
Huh?
What are you doing?
He also talks very pointed and staccato is this guy. Now, to do your Declan Donnelly, what you have to do is always look like you're on the verge of laughing out loud while sharing a cheeky little in-joke with members of the crew. Gary on camera two, he gets it.
No one ever tries to do me.
I hear the Ivers!
Talent. Who's this?
If Declan Donnelly ever decided if... if Declan decided to go into politics, what you'd have to do is send him to Eton, lower his voice, and then you would have, this chap. Now, to do your Boris, you have to, talk at different speeds whilst looking like you've been up all night downing tequila in a bush. Good night. Thank you.
Welcome to From Celebrity Restaurant Kale! Thought I'd tell myself. Wow, look at that lady. She's got lovely bangers and mash. Right, let me introduce Dick, our maitre, Geordie. Tell us what's on menu, but be nice and short. Nice and short, that's me. Gary on camera too, still loving it. Well, I'm too busy being utterly adorable to work in a restaurant, ladies and gentlemen, but luckily I know someone who'll do it. So if I take a step to my right, put some gravel in the throat and a lovely big forehead. I'll just run through the specials. Filet steak drizzled in a red wine and balsamic dew. Portland crab nestled in a bed of lime and mango. Or a kangaroo's knackers. No. I don't want to wear it. Right. You had one task and you failed. Right, what I ordered was boiled potatoes. Right, but these have been dipped in very, very hot fat until they've gone lovely and crispy. You're fried. So I'll just take another order from walking round the restaurant, holding me microphone, pretending not to know where I'm going, desperately trying to create suspense before I choose. You, sir, you look like you're enjoying your meal. And as we all know, a Michelin star restaurant is one of the world's most unforgiving environments. And in this situation, it's important to take protein on board. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have a dead squirrel and a glass of my own pee. Hey, big boy, hey, look at me, yes, hey, hey, where's the scallops? Come on! To create and serve successful scallops, one has to slice, saute, and sear them sensitively so they stay succulent in the center. But sadly, the waiter has stupidly slipped and spilt them. Oi, oi, McPartlin, hey, get over here, yes? You're about to have a kitchen nightmare. Oh no, Ramsay's on the rampage. Get me out of here.
Very good, thanks. What's your name?
Les Gibson.
Hi, Les Gibson?
Yeah.
And what are you doing for us, Les?
I'm doing impressions today.
Brilliant! Good!
At school, I was quite shy. The other kids used to have a sly cigarette behind the bike sheds. And I used to impersonate all the teachers for them. I started doing talent competition, local ones in Blackpool, just to gain experience. And then I started on the clubs in the holiday parks. I've been doing impressions now, full-time for 13 years. Working for myself right now, it can be a very insecure job. It's very hard work, driving up and down the country, wondering where the next gig's coming from. This time when there isn't as many gigs as usual, and you know, you never know what's around the corner.
You get you ready.
Les Gibson.
OK, and how old are you, Les?
I'm 41.
Tell me, what do you do during the day? Do you have a job?
I'm a comedy impressionist and I work on the after-dinner circuit.
And how old were you when you started?
I started doing impressions when I was 11 years old.
All right, do you think you've got what it takes to win this show?
I think I have, yeah.
Good luck.
OK, thank you.
Okay, welcome back to Australia, where the phone lines are now open. So, if you'd like to see Lord Sugar stay in the jungle, dial 090 32 32 01.
That's right, the phone lines are now open.
Is that you?
Don't forget. So, don't forget your vote.
I prefer mine.
That you like to see stay in the camp. So. For Ross Kemp to stay in the jungle, add 02.
And add 03 for Coronation.
I don't think you have Kemp normally. You don't normally sound like that.
So, here they are in the Bush Telegraph, pleading.
Okay, maybe a little bit.
Now, I don't want to hear any more from you two, so get back to the bloody treehouse. Now, the other day, I did one of those Bush took a tasks. And all I got for my dinner was a bloody kangaroo ear and chips and beans. And to be honest with you, I don't like beans. Hi, everybody. Hi, everybody at home. Put your coffee down, eat Jaffa cakes, and tell the kids to shut up. I'm Ross, I'm rough, and I'm tough. Before I came to the jungle, I went to the fairground on a ghost train, front carriage, all on my own.
It's me, Kevin Webster.
That's good.
I'm not doing this for Sophie. I'm not doing it for Roger. I'm doing it for her, Jack. Because she's going to be a mechanic like me and do MOTs every day. Thank you.
Lev, I really, really, really enjoyed it. I thought you were brilliant. I thought you were charismatic. It was brilliant to start with Anton Deck. I don't know what I found funnier, how much I enjoyed you, or the fact that David Hasselhoff has no idea who any of those people are. That just shows you, I can't wait to see what other impressions you can do and to work on. You've obviously got a very versatile, diverse range, and well done. But now for the opinion that counts.
All I can say is I had no idea what you were saying, but I absolutely enjoyed it. Because you were confident, you took the stage, and you know what you're doing. That's what this show's about. Congratulations. Great job, man.
Well done, Les. Obviously, you've been doing this for a long time. You know what works. I'm delighted for you because I thought you were fantastic.
Thank you.
What do you say, yes or no?
Les, it's a definite yes from me. Well done.
Thank you.
It's a yes from me.
What do you say?
You know you're loved. Keep on lifting.
Well done. I was just trying to tell him it was me and Cheryl Cole, wasn't it? That's who, wasn't me and him. He thought it was too camp.
We'll have to keep it quiet all day.
It's Kevin Webster, genius. I'm Ross Kemp. Yeah.
Is he good?
Really good.
It's just a buzz to go on there, and the atmosphere is electric.
Yeah. That must be so weird for you.
But I knew how good he was.
He was so calm.
Good evening, and welcome back to the boardroom. Now, the task I gave you this morning was quite simple, and that was to open your own restaurant. And quite simply, all you had to do was sell and make a profit. Now, Team Ramsay, I believe you had a problem with your bloody menus.
Oh, my God, Lord Sugar, you're absolutely right. When it came to pricing the menus, that's when it turned into a nightmare. Because I gave that responsibility to a little Irishman who has no dress sense, no sense of humour, and he has the personality of a cardboard box. We never sold one meal, and that was all Louis's fault. And Gordon, you're just so insulting. The restaurant business.
business, the restaurant business. I just don't get it. I know nothing, but I've got everything. I'm an all-rounder, and I just want to be in the final.
Hey, Walshy! Stop acting like a little crying baby. You let the team down. I know all about business. I've got my own garage. I fix cars. I get crushed by them every day!
Now, Team Kemp, Ross, you put yourself forward as team leader. Confident in yourself. Oi! Brown sugar, or whatever you want to call yourself. Why don't you just shut up? I put myself forward as team leader because the word boss, it rhymes with Ross. And for my team's menu, I created Ross Kemp's Extreme Crispy Chips. My chips are so crispy, they make your gums bleed. And Anton Deck, they never helped with this stupid idea of kangaroo crumble. No, no, cockroach crumble.
That's right, for our menu we created cockroach crumble.
So, if you'd like your cockroach crumble cooked to perfection, place in the oven, gas mark 4 for 15 minutes.
That's right, cooked to perfection, gas mark 4 for 15 minutes.
Well, the cookers are now closed.
And that's time for Les Gibson to say
good night. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent.
Thank you.
What's your name?
Francine Lewis.
Francine Lewis.
Yes.
And do you have a day job, Francine?
Well, I'm a mum. I'm a mum of two, so I do my impressions to entertain everyone when I can.
It's impressions that you do?
Yes. I started doing impressions when I was about six, and then back in the 90s, I entered a talent show and I came second to a puppet. And I carried on for a little while, but I never ever got to the level I always dreamed about. And then I came out of it when I got pregnant. I love being with my kids, I really do, but I wouldn't die happy if I didn't pursue what I feel I should be doing. I've been out of it for quite a while and I just lost all my confidence. Coming back and in front of such a big audience, it's very nerve-wracking, I'm not going to lie. I just feel so lucky to be able to get this second chance today. I just want to go out there and prove that I can do it.
OK, best of luck.
Let's do it.
Oh, my God! Oh, my God! I'm, like, so nervous and so excited. It's like being on The X Factor all over again. Oh, my God. I just love being a celebrity. When my agent said I was doing an advert for Iceland, I rushed out to get a woolly hat, a woolly coat, and a passport.
Hello, honeys. 100%, definitely. You'll come to Amy Charles' salon in Essex. I love Essex. I work in Essex. I live in Essex. It's all about Essex. And I can spell Essex, I think. Oh, shut up. Oh, well, there's only one pricey. As you all know my private life, you'll know I've just got married. Again. I organised it all. The church, the honeymoon, and the divorce lawyer. Hi, I'm Holly Willoughby.
In your face, Holly Willoughby.
And I present everything on ITV. And surprise, surprise, because tonight, Simon Cowell, I reunite you with the gorgeous Cheryl Cole. okay. I'm totally, totally excited to be here.
Oh my God.
Even to see you, Simon. My frenemy. Thank you! Because I'm gonna, my eyelashes will fall off.
Wow.
Oh, that was so lovely.
That
Thank
was
you.
Incredible. Brilliant impressions, brilliant choices of people, all none of which I've seen before. Amazing to be funny and beautiful. I thought it was just me, but you are too.
I love you. Whatever happens in this competition, you are amazing at what you do. I'm speechless.
Thank you.
Brilliant. When you started doing Stacey Sullivan, you didn't even have to speak. It was just the first noise I knew who it was.
Oh, my God.
It was, I know.
I love you.
Most of all, what I really admire about you is how you're not trying to sneak back into the door of show business. You've just stood on a stage of a show with millions of people watching, you're just willing to give it a go to get back out there, and I'm backing you all the way because it was amazing.
Simon.
Those impressions were fantastic. Normally, I don't know who half these people are. They were current, funny, the dialogue was good. And you look amazing, and you put everything together. I really do think we are looking at a future star.
Thank you.
Okay, we've got to vote, first of all. David, yes or no?
It's a yes.
You've got four yeses for.
She's back, back, back!
How are you? Well done.
I didn't think I'd get that emotional, but I did.
I think she's one of my favourites so far.
Really good choices of people.
Cheryl was fantastic.
Cheryl was amazing.
Hello?
Hello, darling. It's Mummy. I got through. Yeah!
I'm happy for you.
Aww, when I'll be home soon, I'll give you a big hug. Apparently, the police had to pull him out of the river. Oh, I say, I mean, what sort of lunatic would go swimming in the River Thames? Oh, just the thoughts give me terrible migraine. Calls me out of play. Now, Papa, let me show you. All right, Sharon. No, duh, I'm not all right. See, my life's like a nursery rhyme. Jack and Phil went up the hill, fighting to get me to the altar. Jack got shot, Phil lost the plot, and I found out I was Miss Piggy's daughter. Hello, honey. 100%, definitely. You've done fantastic. People say to me, Amy, what should I put ethics? And I say, Friday night, you'll see my right, sugar up. And every night, you'll see Arj in pizza up. Oh, shut up. time, I'm back to the Jezzo, Sharon Osbourne. Well, me and my Aussie love this show. And I can't wait to get back on that X Factor with my little Lulu. And it's about blooming time, Simon. Because I'm fabulous, darling. Hey, Simon. Totally, utterly, butterly, distraught. See, me and the girls have split up. People thought it was because we were arguing, but me and Nadine, we never got on, because neither of us could understand a word each other said. I'm pregnant again. And somebody asked me today what I was hoping to have. And I said, another book deal and a reality show.
Nice to meet you. Hello, everyone. Hi.
Hello.
Sorry, bit nervous.
Who are you?
I'm Phil W. Green. I'm 21, and I'm going to be doing comedy impressions.
Yay!
Phil, do you do this full time?
No, I don't, no.
What do you do?
I work at Body Shop at the moment as a customer consultant.
I bet your dream is to be a big international
yes,
star.
Yes, I'd love to be on stage.
I'm Philip Green, I'm 21, and I'm a customer consultant at Body Shop, but it's not what I want to do forever.
Yeah.
Have you ever done anything like this before, then?
Not this, no. Never done it, no. I'm going to go out there and just have a lot. As soon as I'm out there, that's it, can't come off.
You'll be fine.
I have never performed this talent in front of anyone, apart from my friends. I am so nervous to go on that stage in front of all those judges and all those people, because I don't know what they're going to think. Are they going to buzz me? I don't know. I like to think I've got what it takes to win. I like to think that I've got what it takes to win Britain's Got Talent.
Philip, did you bring anyone with you?
So, my friend Christy.
Did she work at Body Shop?
She did, but she's recently left.
Why?
Because she found a better job.
Found a better job!
Sorry!
Where?
She now works at Barrett's, so... Shoes!
I hope he's good after all of this.
OK, well, look, Philip, you've got roughly 2 minutes. Let's do it.
OK. Hello, I'm Natalie Cassidy. And today, we're going to be health working out. So everyone put your hands out in front of you, spread your legs and do some squats. Lie down, the baby, on Martin Fowler's sofa. Isn't that right? Dawn Cotton would be proud, wouldn't she? It's so nice to be here on my wee show. And today's guest is absolutely fantastic. You know what? I'm going to meet her. Hello. Oh, thanks for having me, Charlotte Rain. Oh, I'm so nervous. Oh, come here.
And then, oh, I was on Guana Jungle recently. Oh my God. I mean, I saw those ones and I was like, whoa. And then I saw even more ones and I was like, whoa. And then they tried to make me eat the ones and I was like, whoa. And I was like, whoa, whoa. And then I was being sick everywhere.
Oh my goodness, have you seen the bacteria in here? It is awful. Isn't that right, Kim?
Oh, my love. Oh, that stinks. Dance, it's me, Louis Spence, dancing. Everyone like a duck. Come on, duck. Everyone, come on, duck. Everyone, duck, duck, and down, duck, and down, and Spence! Duck! Oh, ooh, ooh.
I like him a lot.
The brilliant thing about your act was that you had us laughing before you even did anything.
Oh, thanks, Amanda.
David!
You're like a butch version of me. You're a very, very funny guy. I'd like to see some more of you in the act as well. Because you are hysterically funny as you as well.
Are you sure you're not related to Stacey Solomon?
I wish I was. I've seen her from a distance and I was in like, Stacey. But no.
I think you're really funny, lovable.
Do you need a wee?
No, no, no. I'm just really nervous. Sorry.
Simon?
It was like the world record for how many impersonations you can do in 2 minutes. I found it difficult to keep up with some of them. But the ones that were great.
Oh, thanks.
But you are a naturally funny guy.
Oh, thanks.
Slightly bonkers. But I like that.
You're gonna take a vote. David, yes or no?
I'm going to say yes.
It's a yes from me.
Simon?
And we have actually had some good impressionists on the show this year. So you have got some competition. But I am going to say... yes.
Yay! That's four yeses. You're through for the next round.
Thank you so much. It's nice to meet you all. See you soon. Bye-bye. Yeah! Oh, my gosh. Oh,
well
my
done. God. Well done. You did it. You did it. You did it.
Funny guy.
He is very funny.
It might be quite fun to have two impressionists in the final.
In an impression of.
So your first time out on stage doing this, how did it feel?
I'm so glad they laughed. That's all I can say. Like,
good. Yeah. Well, we'll see you again. You got four yeses. Well done. Well
done. Thank you very much. Cheers. Thank
enjoy.
You.
Enjoy.
See you next time. I can't believe it. I was so sorry. I was so good. Oh, my God. Oh.
Hello there. Good morning to you and welcome back to Daybreak. I'm Lorraine Kelly and everything I say sounds so lovely. I mean, literally, just yesterday I was weed on by a wee dog. Isn't that just lovely? Now, brace yourselves for the lovely Natalie Cassidy.
My all new world, run! My all new workout regime is so much better than last week's. I'm going to put all the weight back on just so I can do it again. Some of the moves include the Peggy Mitchell arm swings, the Pat Butcher bottom bounces, and my favourite, the Sonia Trumpet squats. But also forgetting the Phil Mitchell shoulder shrugs. What?
Oh, my God. You never guess what's happened to me. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Hey, Nancy, I've just got a job as an auctioneer. Oh, my God. Right, so what we're going to do, right, is we're going to sell the Grease CD. Oh, my God, I really like it. Oh, my God. Right, so let's start the bidding. I've £35. Oh, my God, £35. 35, 40, Revlon 50, Ding-a-ling 70. Oh, my God. lovely Alicia Dixon. My time, show time, hook line, let's roll, let's rhyme. Scribble on a paper gun and keep this tack. Here we go, get up on a raven's rhyme. Misty with a bump and flex. Enter. Thank you, Alicia. Definitely one of my favourite sugar babes there. Oh dear, wasn't she from the Sugar Babes? Oh no, oh dear, anyway. Right, so I'm going to leave you with my final guest. He's very shy, so please be nice.
Darling, you know, it's part of Dance Studio. Let's start the dance class. Come on, dancers, up we go. 5, 6,